Hi there, I'm Sam from CreativeMinds. In this video, we're going to take a look at four new and useful features available with Marketplace version 1.3. The first new feature allows suppliers to upload multiple products at a time through a CSV import. The second feature allows customers to assign star ratings to vendors based on their satisfaction with an order. The third feature is a new billing report for store administrators, which tracks and simplifies the process of paying suppliers or vendors. The last feature is custom profile fields for suppliers, which the store administrator can create and define. So now we're going to take an in-depth look at what these new features look like and how you can use them to improve performance of your Magento store.
So the first feature we're going to discuss is the CSV Product Import. To enable this feature, you'll need to go to System and then Configuration. Then under Marketplace, you'll go to Configuration and you'll see the CSV Import option. Then you'll need to enable the CSV Import, so you can set this to Yes. You can then set how many products can be imported at one time. If you put 0, this allows vendors to upload unlimited amounts of products at a time. Now let's check out the supplier side. If the supplier goes to Import and then Products, here's the new Upload Products page. On this page, the supplier can upload a CSV file containing multiple products, and they can also upload associated images of those products. For example, let's choose a product image, and then let's go ahead and choose our CSV file that has our sample product in there. So as you can see, the product schema includes name, description, short description, weight, price, the image file associated with the product, etc. So let's go ahead and choose this schema. And now let's import. Now that we have both the picture and the CSV file, and here we go. Now the page tells us that we have successfully uploaded one product. And you can click to get a full report. And this full report will tell you the product ID, product name, and its SKU number. Now let's head over into the admin side of things. If we go to Catalog and then Manage Products, you can see that the admin can see that this new product has been uploaded directly with all of the associated fields, including type of product, quantity, price. It has been uploaded directly into the product directory. The next feature we're going to discuss is the new billing system. In the admin panel, if you go to Suppliers and then Billing Report, in this report we have a list of all of the orders that were created by vendors. The report shows the vendor ID, the order ID, the date of the order status, whether it was completed or not, subtotal, the net income. The paid amount is how much the vendor has been paid for this particular order and on what date the vendor was paid. Owing is how much you have left to pay a vendor. Under Action, if we go to Edit, here you can change the amount that was paid to a vendor. We're going to change it to $7, for example, and then you can save that edit action. And when we return to the billing report, you can see that this edit is reflected in that order record. The third feature we're going to discuss is the supplier's profile fields. So under suppliers, if you go to Manage Profile Fields, so here the admin can create those custom profile fields, which will be added to the supplier's panel, which they can then fill out or will be automatically completed. From the supplier side, on their panel, if they go to Settings and then My Profile page, in the profile info, the name and description, these two fields are created automatically. They are default fields. But as you can see below, the bank account and also terms, these are custom profile fields that the admin can create using this new feature. But the bank account and address fields, these are new fields that the admin can create using this new feature. So I'm just gonna fill out an imaginary bank account number and an imaginary address, just so we can see how these profile fields will be reflected in the vendor profile that the customer has access to and also on the admin side. And then if we head over to the supplier page, the name and the address appear on the supplier page because the bank account information is hidden. Now let's check out the front end. So say you're a customer and you're scrolling through and you click on a product. On the product page, when you click on the name of the vendor, it'll bring you to that supplier's profile page where you can have access to those custom profile fields that the admin allows to be visible to the public. And when we return to the admin side, as you can see in the custom profile fields, the two records we have here are bank account and terms. These are the two fields that are then reflected in that supplier profile. So now let's check out what it looks like to add a new custom field. You can give the field a name, a label, and a description. Keep in mind that this system does not accept spaces or any special characters, so you'll need to put in underscores if you want to have multiple words. For example, bank underscore account. And then for the label, you can freely write whatever you want with spaces, special characters, etc. And then in the second section, we have options for this particular profile field. You can decide whether or not this profile field is required to be filled out by the supplier or not. In system, this lets you control whether or not this information appears on the supplier's page. For example, if we want to hide the bank account information from the supplier's page, you can select no for in system. And then if we go to the supplier page, as you can see, it has the name, description, and terms, but the bank account is hidden. Next, we have the type of field, so it can either be text or text area. You can decide whether or not you want to use what you see is what you get or not. And finally, you can decide whether or not this profile field needs to be approved by the administrator or not. So now our last feature is supplier ratings. Customers can only rate a supplier after an order has been completed and shipped. On the rate vendor page, the customer has a list of all of the suppliers that they have completed orders from. And here they can give each supplier a rating based on their satisfaction with the order. If the customer has already rated a supplier, if they go to My Rates, they can see a list of all of the suppliers and the ratings that they gave to each of these suppliers previously. So now let's check out the supplier ratings from the front end. Say you're a customer scrolling through a site and you click on a product. On that product page, you'll be able to see the vendor's name and also its star rating based on customers' previous ratings on the satisfaction of their orders from that vendor. So on the admin side, if you go to suppliers and then manage suppliers, the admin has access to the star ratings from all of the customers for each of its own suppliers. So if they click on an individual supplier's name, the admin can then go to customer rates, and here they have a list of all of the customers who have rated this particular vendor, the customer's name, customer ID, the rating that the vendor received, and on what date they voted.